A form is a way for a web page to send information to a server. We don't let the web pages here on Khan Academy interact with servers for security reasons, so we don't teach forms here. But now that you are learning JavaScript to manipulate web pages, I can show you how to use JavaScript to process form elements instead of having to send them to a server. I've set up a bunch of form elements on this page to find out the user's name and their language. And I want the web page to say hello to the user in their language once they click this button. The first step is to store the button element in a variable. So we'll just say document.getElementById button. The next step is to define the event listener function. OnButtonClick equals function. And then inside of here, we'll just start with having it append a message. So document.getElementById message. We have a nice little message div. And we'll just text content plus equals, you clicked me. Thank you so much. A very grateful div. Finally, step three, we will add the event listener to the button so that it calls that function when it's clicked. So click on button click. Pause the talk through now and see for yourself that it works like you expected. Now, let's make it actually say something based on what's in the form. We need to figure out how to get whatever the user typed in the name input field. Let's make a variable for it. So var name equals document dot get element by ID, since it had an ID. So we've got that there. Let's make a new string for the greeting and concatenate the name with it. So var greeting equals hey yes, that's my favorite greeting, plus name. Okay, so we've got a string plus whatever's being stored in that variable. And now this here, this text content, should actually be greeting. Let's see, that looks right. We found the name input, we made a greeting string, and we appended it to the div. Pause the talk through and see if it worked. Not quite, right? Did you see heyas object, or heyas object element? Assuming that your name isn't object, and no offense if it is, that's a great name, that means that something's wrong. We expected to see whatever you typed in, but we saw object instead. That means that the name variable is pointing at an object, not the string we expected it to point at. Maybe you've already figured out the problem. We stored the whole element object inside the name variable. And the element object is a big object with lots of information about the element, all of its attributes, all of its methods. To find out what the user typed in, we have to access a particular property of the element, the value. I'll just go ahead and type value, and that should fix it. Pause the talk through, try again. It worked, right? Now that's a common mistake to make, so look out for it. I want to show you one more common mistake. I'll take this line here and move it outside of the function. Now pause the talk through, type in the input, and press the button. If it broke the way it should, then you should have seen an empty string for your name. Have you figured out why? You have to think carefully about when each line of code is executed. In the current code, the browser loads a page and executes the JavaScript line by line. First, it stores the button element in a variable. Then, it stores the value of the input element in the variable. But it stores the value at the time that the page loads, which would be empty. Then it defines a function and assigns the event listener. When the listener is called, the name is still the same string as it was when the page loaded. So the listener never finds out the latest thing that the user typed. That's why this line of code has to be inside this event listener function so that it finds out the value at the time that the event happens. Let's add some code to look at the language value now to make sure you're really getting this. Inside the listener, I'll store the lang in a lang variable. Get my indenting better. Oh, look at this indenting. This is horrible. Let's just line these things up. Okay. So lang equals document.getElementById lang.value. And you'll notice that I am naming my variables the same thing as my IDs, but that's just what I'm doing. You don't have to do that. Now I want to output a different message based on what language they picked. Notice the value isn't what's shown in the dropdown. It's the value attribute in the HTML. So lang should be either en, es, or plt. So that means if lang equals es, then the greeting should be hola. Let's go ahead and make this greeting variable here. So then greeting be hola plus the name. And then if the lang equals plt, good old Pig Latin, the greeting should be hello a plus the name. And then we can just use an else for our English. Just move this in here. All right. Ooh, and if you want a fun bonus challenge, try making a Pig Latin converter for names so that the entire greeting, including their name, gets translated. That'd be pretty neat. Now pause the talk through, enter your name, pick a different language, and try it out. Neat, huh? Now, there's a lot of stuff you can do with form inputs and a little JavaScript. Word games, number games, story makers. And if you do have a server outside of Khan Academy, you can use JavaScript to do pre-processing on form input before sending it to a server. There are also a lot more events you can listen to on forms, like key press and focus events. Just remember to look at the value of the inputs and to check that value at the right time. You'll get to practice that in the next challenge, which is a personal favorite of mine.